Hi, you guys. I just wanted to tell you that I wasn't going to have any dessert tonight, and I changed my mind, and I decided to make ice cream. So, it's not that cold, so I thought ice cream's a really nice thing to have after you've had a nice dinner. So, I did the vanilla for tonight, but I wanted to share with you something I did wrong last time, and I paid the price for it. Oh, what a mess I had on my hands. There's a collar on here that's the same exact color as what's the edging around this stainless steel. And I, for some reason, didn't remember there was two pieces. I thought there was just the one. So I was trying to make this thing sit on top with the other one, and it just kept jumping all over the place. And I finally looked around and I saw the collar sitting in my drain board and thought, oh, heavens to Betsy. So I grabbed it and I reassembled it and got it started again. But it was, I had to hold on to it with both hands because it was still on wrong. What I didn't do, you put the outside collar over the inside collar, the two collars together. Then you set the bowl inside of those two. Then you put this clear thing on top of that. Now, what I had done before, I put the bowl that was the freezing bowl down in the bottom with just the stainless steel and the one collar color. And then I tried to put this other collar on top of it with this plastic thing, and it would not stay in place. It jumped all over the place. I didn't know what I had done. And tonight, the penny dropped. And I realized, oh, you cuckoo lady, you put it in backwards. You put the wrong thing in. So just fair warning, if you get one of these, you assemble the two colorful ones together first, then put the freezer bowl in, and it will sit on the ledge inside of this top color one, and then you put your clear one in, but you have the assembly for the motor and the clear one and the spatula, all of it is assembled ready to go. So when you put the bowl in, you can put this whole unit on top of it and get it started and then pour in your liquid. And it worked like a charm. Bob's your uncle. But I thought I better warn you, because if I did it wrong, chances are somebody else might do it wrong too, just because they don't know either. So I wanted to share that with you. It was a mess. Oh my goodness. I had this black unit was trying to jump out. This clear unit was trying to jump out. And then everything was rotating. And I took both hands and held it in place. And by golly, I got the ice cream made. I had to estimate how much time I had lost. It's all just one big puzzle, isn't it? But anyway, I wanted to share that with you and tell you it's so fast. I started at 6:30 and it's 6:43 right now, and there's 20 minutes left. So 6:30 plus 6:43, about 3 after. It's about a 35 minute once you get it going. It takes a little bit. You have to pour all the measurements out of the milk and the cream and then mix in your powder. And then once that's in the bowl and ready to go, it's about 35 minutes. So I've tried longer. I've tried 35. I've tried 25. They suggest 25 to 35. My favorite is 30. So I set it on 30 today. Okay, that's all I wanted to share. And I just wanted to tell you that it's that easy to have a dessert on hand when you didn't go and buy anything special. You can whip this up really fast. And it's not that hard once you know what you're doing. And in this case, I did today. Yay! Bon appetit, you guys. Let me just give you the box of what I use again. This one is from Amazon. And there's one other one that they sell that's about a little cheaper, I think. But I like the junket. I've been able to do one quart at a time with it. And it works just great. But they do two quarts for about the same price on another brand. And you might want to try that and see if that's good for you. Okay, bon appetit. Bye-bye.